Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In this module of convex optimization course, we will continue our discussion on duality. In particular, we will talk about Karoush, Cohen, Tucker optimality conditions, and later we will review some examples to demonstrate the use of KKT conditions in solving optimization problems. Before we look at KKT optimality conditions, let us quickly review the concepts which we studied in the previous module. So for a primal optimization problem in which we minimize objective function subject to some inequality constraints and equality constraints, and this primal optimization problem does not need to be convex. So for this primal problem, we can formulate a Lagrange dual problem in which we maximize Lagrange dual function g lambda mu subject to Lagrange dual variable lambda greater than or equal to zero. And we note that this Lagrange dual problem is a convex optimization problem because we maximize a concave function. And we also studied that the solution of the Lagrange dual problem, or optimal value of the Lagrange dual problem, serves as a lower bound on the optimal value of the primal optimization problem. So mathematically, it means that g lambda star mu star, which is we denote by d star, that is less than or equal to p star, or d star is a lower bound on p star. And the difference between p star and d star is denoted by duality gap. So duality gap is given by p star minus d star. If p star is less than equal to d star, we say we have a weak duality. And when p star is equal to d star, that means duality gap is equal to zero, we say we have a strong duality. Among the condition that establishes strong duality, the Slater's constraint qualification or Slater's condition is very simple but very powerful for convex optimization problems. So we say Slater's condition establishes strong duality. Let's talk about optimality conditions. So for a primal optimization problem, we formulated a Lagrange dual problem, and optimal value of a primal optimization problem is noted by p star, and that for a Lagrange dual problem is noted by d star. So what we know that d star serves as a lower bound on p star. So let's also denote the solution of a primal optimization problem by x star, and the solution of a Lagrange dual problem is given by lambda star and mu star. So x star and lambda star mu star represent the optimal points for primal optimization problem and Lagrange dual problem respectively. So previously we related d star with p star, that d star serves as a lower bound on p star, but we should also establish the relationship between the optimal point of a primal problem and optimal point of a Lagrange dual problem. So the question under consideration in this module is that what are the optimality conditions that are required to be satisfied by primal and dual optimal points? To answer this question, we have Karoush, Cohen, Tucker optimality conditions, or Karoush, Cohen, Tucker theorem, abbreviated as KKT conditions or KKT theorem. So these conditions establish a relationship between x star, solution to the primal problem, and lambda star mu star, that are the optimal points of the Lagrange dual problem. So these conditions establish a unified framework for optimization problems. In some textbooks, these KKT conditions are also referred to as saddle point theorem. Let's look at these KKT conditions. So we start with some assumptions. So we assume that the objective function and inequality constraint functions and equality constraint functions are differentiable. And we assume that the optimal points are given by x star and lambda star mu star. So x star is an optimal solution of a primal problem, and lambda star mu star are the optimal points of a Lagrange dual problem. And we also assume that strong duality holds, that means duality gap is zero. With these assumptions, we define KKT conditions that must be satisfied by these optimal points x star, lambda star, and mu star. Among KKT conditions, the first condition is primal feasibility. As the name suggests, it simply means that we require X star optimal point of our primal optimization problems must satisfy inequality constraints and equality constraints. Mathematically, it simply means that fi of x star should be less than equal to 0 for I is equal to 1, 2, 2m. And hj of x star should be equal to 0 for j is equal to 1, 2, to p. So these two equations simply means that x star is primal feasible, or x star satisfies primal feasibility, or x star belongs to the feasible set of a primal optimization problem. Okay, the condition two is the dual feasibility. That means for a Lagrange dual problem, the optimal point lambda star and mu star must satisfy the constraints of a Lagrange dual problem. And for a Lagrange dual problem, we only have one constraint, that lambda should be greater than or equal to 0. It simply means that we require lambda star should be greater than or equal to 0, or lambda I star greater than or equal to 0 for I is equal to 1, 2, to m. So this is a dual feasibility. Condition 1 and condition 2 simply originate from the requirement of a primal problem to be feasible and dual problem to be feasible, respectively. Let's talk about condition 3, which we call complementary slackness. Let me define this condition first, and then we will derive it. So this condition is that lambda I star fi of x star is equal to 0 for I is equal to 1, 2 to m. Where does it come from? Let us quickly derive this. To derive this complementary slackness condition, so we take 3 points, x star, lambda star, mu star. So x star is primal optimal, lambda star, mu star are dual optimal. So what we know, that objective function of the primal problem is equal to the objective function of the Lagrange dual problem at optimal points. And so that means f naught of x star should be equal to g lambda star mu star, and it simply stems from the fact that d star is equal to p star, or we had this strong duality assumption. And we know that this Lagrange dual function is the infimum of the Lagrangian over x. So let us define this g lambda star mu star, that this is given by infimum of x, and we have f naught of x plus inequality constraints, and we have equality constraints. So this is the Lagrangian, and we're taking infimum over Lagrangian, and we get this Lagrange dual function evaluated at lambda star and mu star. And since x star is feasible, so we can say that this infimum is less than or equal to f naught of x star plus inequality constraint functions evaluated x star and equality constraints evaluated x star. This is simply Lagrangian, and we evaluate Lagrangian at x is equal to x star, and this is greater than or equal to infimum of the Lagrangian over all x. And since x star is primal feasible, that means this quantity is negative. Lambda I star is dual feasible, that means this is non-negative. And this quantity would be zero since x star is primal feasible. So we can say that in fact this is less than or equal to objective function at x star. In fact, this is the same as what we had here. It simply means that, so these inequalities are in fact can be replaced with equalities. So we can replace this inequality with equality, and we can also replace this inequality with equality. So it simply means that this quantity is equal to zero, or in fact, if this is f naught of x star, this is f naught of x star, so this whole term would be equal to zero. Or since this is zero, since x star is x star is primal optimal, so this term is zero, and we say that, so when this is zero, we have this term equal to zero. Or since fi is negative, in fact, fi is less than equal to zero and lambda is greater than equal to zero, this simply means each term is equal to zero, and this is what we have for this is what we call complementary slackness. It simply means that when lambda I star is greater than or equal to zero, fi of x star must be equal to zero, or when fi of star is equal less than zero, lambda I star must be equal to zero, because the product of lambda I star and fi of x star should be equal to zero, and we refer to this condition as complementary slackness, and it has these two implications. Or it simply means that lambda I star is zero unless inequality constraint is active at the optimal x star. Let's move on to last KKT condition, condition four, that is stationarity. So we define Lagrangian for a primal optimization problem using Lagrange dual variables as Lagrangian x lambda star mu star is given by objective plus inequality constraints, and we have equality constraints. For lambda I, we use lambda I star, and for mu j, we're using the optimal dual point mu j star. And we know that the x star, which is optimal point of a primal problem, that minimizes this Lagrangian. And the consequence of this is that when you evaluate the gradient of the Lagrangian with respect to x, at x is equal to x star, that gradient should be equal to zero, right? So mathematically it means that gradient of a Lagrangian, so evaluated at x star, is given by gradient of objective function at x star plus inequality constraints, and we have the gradient of inequality constraint functions, and here we have gradient of equality constraint function. And we evaluate these gradients at x star. So since x star minimizes Lagrangian, so this gradient should be equal to zero. This condition, that the gradient of the Lagrangian with respect to x should be zero at x is equal to x star, that is the optimal point of the primal optimization problems. So we refer to this condition as stationarity condition. So we have four conditions. The first one was primal feasible. That means that x star is chosen such that inequality constraint functions and equality constraint functions of a primal optimization problem are satisfied. And then the second condition was dual feasibility. So that lambda I star is greater than equal to zero, I is equal to 1 to m. And then we had complementary slackness. Mathematically it means lambda I star fi of x star should be equal to zero for I is equal to 1 to m. And finally we had the fourth KKT condition, that is stationarity. And this condition states that gradient of a Lagrangian at x star mu star lambda star should be equal to zero, and this gradient is with respect to x. Let us also state the assumptions we had earlier. So we assume that optimal points are x star, lambda star, mu star, that x star is optimal point of the primal optimization problem, and lambda star, mu star are the optimal points of the Lagrange dual problem. And we also assumed that strong duality holds, or duality gap is zero. So with these assumptions, x star, lambda star, mu star must satisfy Karush, Cohen, Tucker optimality conditions. Let us summarize this whole discussion about KKT optimality conditions. I again emphasize that we did not assume the primal problem to be convex. So we did not have any convexity assumption. And we only assume that we have strong duality or duality gap is zero. So, and what we've shown that optimal points x star and lambda star mu star must satisfy KKT conditions. Or we can say for primal non-convex problems, we have a necessary condition that states that primal optimal x star and dual optimal lambda star mu star satisfy KKT conditions if the duality gap is equal to zero. Let's talk about a case when the primal optimization problem is a convex optimization problem. So when primal problem is a convex problem, these KKT conditions become sufficient conditions for strong duality. So we assume that primal optimization problem is convex, and if x tilde and lambda tilde mu tilde are any points that satisfy KKT conditions, then x tilde is primal optimal and lambda tilde mu tilde are dual optimal with zero duality gap. Okay, it simply means that if you take any x tilde for a primal optimization problem and lambda tilde mu tilde as dual variables, and these points together satisfy KKT conditions. If these points satisfy KKT conditions, then x tilde is a solution of a primal problem and lambda tilde mu tilde are solution of Lagrange dual problem, and the duality gap, the d star minus p star, should be equal to zero. Right? Or this all can be summarized that any points x tilde and dual optimal lambda tilde mu tilde that satisfy KKT conditions are primal and dual optimal solutions respectively with zero duality gap. So we summarize these KKT conditions, that these KKT conditions are always sufficient and in fact become necessary when strong duality holds. Since these KKT conditions are necessary for optimality, but under a strong duality assumption, so we can characterize a primal solution from the dual solution using these KKT conditions. So these KKT conditions play a significant role in overall optimization framework. So many algorithms attempt to solve these KKT conditions to solve an optimization problem. In some cases, we can also solve these KKT conditions analytically and to solve optimization problems. Let's look at a couple of examples in which we will solve these KKT conditions analytically to obtain a solution of an optimization problem. We start with a first example in which we minimize a very simple function, and that we minimize 2x squared plus y squared plus 4z squared, and subject to we have x plus 2y minus z is equal to 6, and we have 2x minus 2y plus 3z is equal to 12, right? So, and this is in fact a quadratic problem. Objective function is convex quadratic, and we have a fine equality constraint. We will use KKT conditions to solve this optimization problem. The first condition was primal feasibility. So it simply requires that optimal XYZ must satisfy the constraints of the problem. Here we only have equality constraints, so we the primal feasibility condition simply requires that equality constraints hold. So we do not have any inequality constraint here, and therefore we do not have any lambda in the formulation of Lagrangian, or consequently we do not have any equation resulting from the dual feasibility condition, since there is no lambda. For the same reason, we will not have any equation resulting from the condition of complementary slackness. So we have talked about primal feasibility, dual feasibility, complementary slackness. The fourth condition is stationarity. So it requires that gradient of a Lagrangian is zero. So here we take gradient of the Lagrangian with respect to primal variables x, y, z. So let's quickly formulate the Lagrangian first. So Lagrangian is given by a Lagrangian x, y, z, mu 1 and mu 2. Since we have two equality constraints, we have two Lagrange dual variables associated with equality constraints. So Lagrangian is given by objective function plus mu 1 times equality constraint and mu 2 times second equality constraint. When we take gradient of this with respect to x, y, and z, so we get a vector in R3. So gradient is given by when you take derivative with respect to x. So we get 4x minus mu 1 minus 2 mu 2, and derivative with respect to y would be 2y minus 2 mu 1 minus 2 mu 2, and derivative with respect to z would be 8z plus mu 1 minus 3 mu 2. So since we require this gradient is equal to 0, and if we also write down these equality constraints, so these equations what we had here, since the primal feasibility condition requires equality constraint to hold, so let me also rewrite these two constraint equations here. So x plus 2 y minus z is equal to 6, and 2 x minus 2 y plus 3 z is equal to 12. So you can say in total we have these five equations, and we have five variables here. So three equations that come from the gradient, and two equations which are defined by these constraints. So in total we have five variables, and we can say we have five equations. So we can solve this system of equations to determine x, y, z, mu 1, mu 2 analytically. And since these variables satisfy KKT conditions, and the problem is convex, so we say these variables must be primal optimal and dual optimal, and since they satisfy KKT conditions, the duality gap should be equal to 0. In this example, we minimize a linear function in R2, that is 2x1 plus 2x2. So x belongs to R2, and we have constraints that subject to x1 squared plus x2 squared less than equal to 9, and x1 is less than equal to x2. So we have two inequality constraints, and we have a linear objective function. So let me rewrite this inequality constraints in standard form. So we write x1 squared plus x2 squared minus 9 less than equal to 0. And second constraint, we can express x1 minus x2 less than equal to 0. And we note here that this constraint function is convex. And the second constraint function is also convex. Objective function is linear. So we can say we have a convex optimization problem. So we will use KKT conditions to solve this optimization problem to obtain an analytical solution. So we first formulate Lagrangian for this primal optimization problem. So Lagrangian would be given by a Lagrangian function of x1, x2. Since we have two inequality constraints, we have two Lagrange dual variables, lambda 1, lambda 2. So lambda 1 is associated with x1 squared plus x2 squared minus 9, and lambda 2 is associated with x1 minus x2. So we formulate Lagrangian as objective function plus lambda 1 times inequality constraint and plus lambda 2 times the other inequality constraint. So this is the Lagrangian we have. So now let's use KKT conditions to obtain analytical solution. So the first KKT condition is primal feasibility, and that requires that inequality constraint functions should hold for optimal x1 x2. So we say primal feasibility condition implies x1 squared plus x2 squared less than equal to 9 and x1 minus x2 less than equal to 0. And we have the next condition is the dual feasibility. For this condition we require lambda 1 should be greater than equal to 0 and lambda 2 should be greater than equal to 0. So this is the dual feasibility condition. So we have these two KKT conditions. The next KKT condition is the complementary slackness. So the complementary slackness condition requires that lambda 1 times x1 squared plus x2 squared minus 9 is equal to 0. And we also have another complementary slackness condition, that lambda 2 x1 minus x2 is equal to 0. So we can, this is a lambda 1 f1 of x, lambda 2 f2 of x. So this is these two equations result from the complementary slackness condition. Okay, next we have stationarity condition. For stationarity condition implies that derivative of the Lagrangian with respect to x1 should be equal to 0 and derivative of Lagrangian with respect to x2 is equal to 0. When you take derivative with respect to x1, so we get 2 plus 2 lambda 1 x1 plus lambda 2 is equal to 0, and when we take derivative of Lagrangian with respect to x2, so we get 1 plus 2 x2 lambda 1 minus lambda 2 is equal to 0. So we have these conditions, and different conditions resulting from different KKT conditions. So now we will use these conditions together to obtain x1, x2, lambda 1, and lambda 2. So we have these KKT conditions, or these equations resulting from KKT conditions. So we start with this complementary slackness equations. So we have two equations here. So if you see, we have a product of two quantities here, lambda 1 and x1 squared plus x2 squared minus 9 is equal to 0. So these two conditions, we can obtain four cases. So we can say, so these two conditions imply that either lambda 1 is equal to 0 and lambda 2 is equal to 0. And second condition is lambda 1 is equal to 0 and x1 is equal to x2. And third condition is that lambda 2 is equal to 0 and x1 squared plus x2 squared minus 9 is equal to 0. And the fourth case could be that x1 is equal to x2 and x1 squared plus x2 squared minus 9 is equal to 0. So these four cases result from these two complementary slackness equations. Okay, let's start analyzing these cases one by one. So let's start with case one. So in case one, lambda 1 is equal to 0 and lambda 2 is equal to 0. If we substitute these two lambdas in the stationarity equations, so we substitute in the stationarity equation, when we substitute lambda 1 is equal to 0 in this equation, we get 2 plus 0, lambda 2 is also 0, we get 2 is equal to 0, so which is not possible. And if you substitute this in the second condition, we get 1 is equal to 0. And obviously this is not possible. So we can say, so case 1 is not valid, or case 1 is not possible. Okay, let's start analyzing case 2. So case 2, lambda 1 is equal to 0. When we substitute lambda 1 is equal to 0 in these stationarity equations, so we get lambda 2 is equal to minus 2 from the first equation, and we get lambda 2 is equal to minus 1 from the second equation. So again, this is not possible. Okay, let's talk about case 3, when we take lambda 2 is equal to 0. And when you substitute lambda 2 is equal to 0 in these two equations, so we obtain 2 plus 2 lambda 1 x1 is equal to 0 from the first equation, and 1 plus 2 x2 lambda 1 is equal to 0 from the second equation. And so from here we can say x1 is equal to minus 1 over lambda 1, and from the second equation we say x2 is equal to minus 1 over 2 lambda 1. Right, and when we substitute these two conditions in this complementary slackness condition, x1 square plus x2 square minus 9 is equal to 0. So we have x1 square plus x2 square is equal to 9. If I substitute this x1 minus 1 over lambda 1 and x2 is equal to minus 1 over 2 lambda 1 in this equation, I obtain 1 over lambda 1 square plus 1 over 4 lambda 1 square is equal to 9. And if you simplify this one, what you get is lambda 1 square is equal to 5 over 36. And since lambda has to be non-negative from the dual feasibility condition, so this condition, so lambda 1 should be equal to square root 5 over 6. And when you substitute this lambda square, sorry, when you substitute this square root 5 over 6 in these two equations, so we obtain x1 is equal to 6 over minus 6 over square root 5, and x2 is equal to minus 3 over square root 5. So this lambda 1, x1, x2, and lambda 2 is equal to 0. So these together satisfy KKT conditions. In fact, we have obtained lambda 1 is equal to square root 5 over 6, lambda 2 is equal to 0, x1 is minus 6 over square root 5, x2 is minus 3 over square root 5, using KKT conditions. So these must satisfy KKT conditions. And since the problem is convex, we note that these x1, x2, lambda 1, lambda 2 are in fact primal optimal and dual optimal respectively with zero duality gap. Let's look at one more example in which we minimize, so x belongs to Rn, and we say we have a convex quadratic function, half x transpose bx plus q transpose x plus r, and subject to equality constraints ax is equal to b. So we say that we have equality constraint quadratic program, and obviously we require p to be positive semi-definite, and we take A belongs to RP cross N. So we have P number of equality constraints. So we want to use KKT conditions to solve this optimization problem and obtain analytical solution. We first formulate Lagrangian. Lagrangian is given by a function of X and mu, since we do not have any inequality constraint here. So L Lagrangian would be x mu, and given by objective function plus ax minus b transpose mu. So equality constraints times a dual variable mu. So now we will use KKT conditions to solve this problem. The first KKT condition is primal feasibility. It simply requires equality constraint function to hold. For primal feasibility, we require ax is equal to b. We do not have any lambda here, so we do not need to use the dual feasibility condition and also complementary slackness condition in this problem. So we talk about stationarity condition. We take derivative, we take gradient of the Lagrangian with respect to x. When we take gradient of Lagrangian with respect to x, what we get is phi x plus q plus a transpose mu, and KKT condition requires that gradient should be equal to 0. So we have p number of equations here, and we have n number of equations here. So if we concatenate these two equations and we represent in matrix form, so we can write it as that we require 0 into A and A transpose P and times with a vector mu x. So we have two variables here. Mu is a variable, x is a variable. We know A and we know P, because A defines equality constraints and B defines objective function of the primal problem. And that should be equal to that AX should be equal to B, and A transpose mu plus P times X should be equal to minus Q. So we have this. So using this matrix formulation, we can determine mu and X, since we have P plus N variables and we have P plus N equations. So this system of equations can be used to determine mu and X analytically. With this, we converge our discussion. So in this module, we have talked about Karush, Cohen, Tucker optimality conditions. So we have four conditions. We have primal feasibility, dual feasibility, complementary slackness, and stationarity. So these are the four KKT conditions that play a very significant and important role in optimization. We have also talked about a couple of examples in which we used KKT conditions to obtain or to solve optimization problem analytically. In the next module, we will talk about one application in wireless communication in which we will maximize the sum rate or capacity of a MIMO communication channel utilizing these KKT conditions. So we stop here, and we will continue in the subsequent module. Thank you very much.